While I'm over here, I'm going to meet someone for a cuppa, and I'm very late. I don't like to be late, and I'm actually 22 years late. I was doing a season of stand-up in London in 1990, and I had a letter from Morrissey inviting me for a cup of tea. Anyway, I couldn't go. To make amends, I've brought him a tea cosy knitted by my friend Nora. I've seen Morrissey on a documentary having tea with Nancy Sinatra, and he has a plain white teapot. It's a black and white tea cosy, so it's going to look great. Oh.
Is this your own teapot?
This is mine. This travels with me. I bought it in Rome, but it's Parisian.
What sort of tea is this that we're drinking?
We are drinking Ceylon tea.
Yeah.
And it's very weak.
Yeah.
I mean, the bag skims the surface of the water and is removed. The bag, yes. I mean, I know you're a caddy person, but
I was hoping you might come out of the caddy.
Yeah, but some of us don't remember World War II. I am, though, a teaholic.
Yeah.
Even though I don't have very strong tea.
How often? What time do you kick off with it?
Well, as soon as I wake up, I must have tea.
Mm.
I think one day, because I've never had coffee, you see, one day I decided to try to have a complete day without tea. And I was quite shaken. I was quite disturbed.
Mm. But yeah. It's interesting. We just went to see this. We went to this tea shop, Tea and Sympathy, where the whole point of it is to encapsulate Britishness.
Mm.
And people go and think they're having a British experience. But actually, if you went to Britain, there wouldn't be a tea shop like that.
No, but there was once.
Yes.
There was once, and it was a very British thing.
Mm.
And it was a very stoic thing, and it was the solution to everything, and calm you down, a
yes,
nice cup of tea.
You down,
I mean, nobody
you
ever
up.
Said, I'll make you a horrible cup of tea. It was always, I'll make you a nice cup
yes.
of tea. I mean, why did it have to be nice? Why does it make you a really raunchy cup of tea? So I think it was very British, and part of the British resolve and the reason why Hitler really couldn't get us was because of tea and nothing else. And
I know, but that's so strange, isn't it, when you think it's just a hot drink. And why not cocoa?
There's bound to be a reason.
But I'm going to give you something, but you don't have to have it.
Please don't say it's a tea caddy.
It's not a tea caddy. Does it look like a tea caddy?
A tea cosy.
It was. Doesn't matter. I'm not going to give it you now. It's all right. It doesn't matter.
I knew it was a tea cosy. Come on, let's see it now.
No, we don't want to waste further film. No, because it's not going to match a teapot. I don't care what you say about it now.
This is a beanie hat.
It's got holes for the spout.
This is what the skateboarding kids wear. Reduced to clear, made in Morecambe.
Just give it me back. I'll give it back to Nora.
No, I will keep it, and I shall cherish it because it's...
I don't want you to.
No, I don't say I'm going to use it. I just I'm going to keep it.
Okay.
In a bottom drawer.
In a bottom drawer.
In
when
a
you
back
get married.
Bedroom, okay. Where nobody goes.
Yeah. All right.
So
yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
For your generosity.
You know what? I love Morrissey, and he has a point about Hitler and the British and tea. All those things that made us seem rather dull before the war. Our love of routine. Our reluctance to engage in hysterics.